Well, a priest is a follower of Jesus, and he follows the Lord's life, death, and resurrection. So a priest must be familiar with Golgotha, with Calvary, and not be scared by it or find it too illogical, like many in the world do. He must be able to learn the grammar of the cross and see in the tree of defeat the tree of victory, and to be able to explain that in an articulate manner to the world in which we live today.
As I'm standing there staring into the mirror, it's in the figure of a man trying to take a stand and live for something more. Integrity is what an honor to my soul. I figure it up, pack it in, getting rid of all my sin, weighing me down. Won't you come and fill? Said I want you to come and make me more.
Prayer is the main way that we hear the voice of God speaking to us. So it's important for men who are thinking of a vocation to spend time in silent prayer, certainly, but time in all sorts of different prayers. But the silence of prayer is very important, because that's when God speaks to us.
It's about love and caring for the people, and often in the world we see the cross as a sign of sufferings, but for us, with our faith, we see the cross as a sign of love, of serving others.
Trying to step through the height and the depth of a long narrow road as I'm growing old, and soon I will be home. Won't you come?
It reminds me of what Christ has done for me, which points me towards what the priesthood is really all about. Offering myself in his service for others and to bring others close to him.
The passage of scripture that comes to me is when Jesus said, I'm the good shepherd, I know my own and they know me. And I think this is an important scripture text for a priest, because he is to follow in a very radical way Jesus, the good shepherd.
Won't you come and make.
My advice to anybody considering a priestly vocation is to become comfortable with silence, because the mother tongue of God is silence, and God whispers in the heart, the human heart, a vocation, and it's discerned in silence and through the church. So I would say practice silence, pray particularly in adoration in front of the Eucharist, in front of the presence of the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, both within the Mass and outside the Mass.
The thing that would come to me straight away would be to get to know other young men that are thinking of the priesthood. The fraternity that comes from going on a journey with other people who are thinking of the same things is enormously helpful.
The fount of salvation on which we will stand. The fount of salvation.
Simply entrust your life to Christ and his providence, to recognize that he created you, and that he loves you and gave himself on the cross, and that he's all powerful. And if you hand your life over to him, he'll guide you, he'll lay the steps in front of you. And so every day, entrust your life to God, and he will lead you to your vocation. Perhaps that might be the priesthood.
Send us out to be your hands and feet. Send us out to be your hands and feet. Send us out to be your hands and feet. Send us out to be your hands and feet.
Well, you know, they said, if you never, never go, you will never, never know. So to all the young men, why don't you give it a go?